Hey you mob, welcome to Deadly Kindies. My name is Kendi. I work in the Deadly Kindies team and I also work over at Birthing in Our Community on the south side. So shout out to any of the Jarjans or families over there. And I've got a special friend with me here today.
Hi everyone, I'm Talisha Harden. I'm a Deadly Choices ambassador, but also a speech pathologist with the Institute for Urban Indigenous Health. So thanks so much for having me today.
You're welcome, sis. So we're going to start the session off with an acknowledgement of country. So you can do this one at home too, or at kindy if you're watching along. Here is the land, here is the sky, here are my friends, and here am I. We would like to acknowledge the traditional owners on the land on which we play, discover, and learn. All right, shall we get into it?
Let's do it.
Okay, so we are making some pasta, colored pasta necklaces. So it's like beading. I had this pasta that had been sitting in my cupboard for a long time. And I thought this is a really cheap alternative to going out and buying some beads, because beads can be quite expensive. You know, a packet of this pasta might be 60 cents. So if you've got some pasta at home, that's, you know, you might even have macaroni pasta or a certain type of pasta that you have at home. As long as it's got two holes down either end, you can thread it through and make a necklace. So let's get started. The ingredients for this activity are pretty simple. We need some vinegar and food coloring. So lots of families will have these things at home ready to go already. Shall we start?
Let's do it. I think the first time I ever saw these pasta necklaces was Murray Carnival a few years ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really, really exciting. I love making these.
Yeah, it's fun. Hey, and you know what? The first time I saw this was actually when I was in kindy. So this has been an activity that's been around for a long time. But let's get into it, hey? So I will open the bag up. And if you'd like to pour in some of the vinegar.
Yep, just a splash of vinegar.
A splash, that's it. Little bit, perfect, that's enough.
That'll do.
And what color are you gonna choose?
I might go red.
All right, yeah. Let's do red. I'll hold it up so everyone can see. So just a little bit of food coloring, hey? You might like to get an adult to help you with this one, because food coloring can dye your hands. I've been working in kindies for a long time, and the amount of days that I would go home with red hands, blue hands, and they'd still be there the next day.
Yep.
But also, you know, it's okay. It does wash off eventually, but if you'd like to be careful, ask an adult for some help. All right, sis, next up.
The pasta.
The pasta. So we're gonna do two today. So we're gonna split the pasta in half. So you pop it in the bag.
Little bit more.
That's right. And you can turn this into, you know, math. You could count out your pasta, see how many pieces are in there. Let's have a look. Ziploc that up. And I'll let you do the honors. So all you need to do is just squeeze the pasta around. Can you hear that noise? It almost sounds a bit like.
It does.
Doesn't it? Actually, let's hear our instrument. And shake them all around.
Yeah, and it's really good for you. I guess the little muscles in your hands as well.
Right.
Yeah. Try and use them.
It's almost like giving it a little massage, you know? Get your fingers and your hand muscles moving, get them strong.
Try and cover all the pasta.
Yeah, it takes a little while. So, you know, you could like have a little go, pass it to your brother, have a little go, pass it to your sister. Everyone can get involved. That's looking pretty good though. What do you reckon? Can everybody see that? So now we're going to tip it out to dry. So with this activity, a little bit of patience is involved. So we tip it out and it doesn't take very long. We made these at playgroup last week and they were only out in the sun for about 15 minutes because it was quite warm that day. And you can see it starts to get a bit stuck.
Right at the end.
Yeah, doesn't it? And the best way to get it to dry, I'm going to use the scissors because I don't want my hands to turn red. Let's just spread it out a little bit. That way it can dry evenly. There we go.
Looks
Should
cool.
we do one more color?
Yeah, what color would you like?
Oh,
what are you thinking?
I'm feeling blue today.
Okay.
I think we'll go with blue.
Perfect.
We'll put that in. Little splash of vinegar. And that's just white vinegar that you can use from your kitchen if you have that at home. And here we go. Just a bit of blue. Perfect. And I'm gonna just dip this one in. There we go. Oh, a little bit left. And ziplock that up. And there we go. You could maybe try rolling it around. Mm. Give it a good mix. I've made mine a bit cushiony there. There's a lot of air in the bag, but you could push all the air out. Makes it nice and tight in there. But look, that's covering it real easy. And that feels fun. And listen to that noise. Ooh, I like that.
It's a nice blue color too,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it's beautiful. And look, how easy is that? Get it out. Dip it on our tray to dry. If it comes out, there we are. And you can spread them out. You can use tongs to spread it out. Anything that you might have at home, you might could even use a stick, you know. It's easy there. So there we've got red and blue. Deadly. So out in the sun, about 15 minutes. You could leave it longer if it's a really hot day, maybe even shorter. Just see how you go. You'll be able to, when you see it, you know when it looks dry. You'll be able to tell by your eyes. Shall we get on to making our necklace?
Yeah, let's do it.
Here we go. Here's a piece of, now this is just elastic. You can use, if you have elastic at home, you can use string, whatever you like, but we've chosen elastic. That's safer for the bubs, you know, because they can pull it up and over their neck. Doesn't get stuck on there. So here's the tricky part. We need to thread it on, but not thread it off the other end. So we need to try and balance it. I'm gonna do the flag colors. So I'm gonna go black and push it through. Oh, how's my fine motor skills? Even practicing when you're older too, you know?
They are a bit tricky sometimes, aren't they? I'm gonna go the flag colors of the Torres Strait Islander flag.
There you go, deadly.
Blue and green. We don't have any white, but that's okay. We can do.
Blue and green will be good too.
That'll be really good, yeah.
Thread it through. And like I said before, you know, this is great for, you know, math concepts, counting them out. You can talk about colors, patterning, sequencing, trying to remember the flag colors and what order it goes. You can do any color. You could do rainbow ones, whatever suits you.
Yeah, this is awesome. I'm loving this.
It's good, hey.
Good concentration activity, yeah. Too. You really do have to concentrate and make sure that you're kind of, you know, sticking on task. And
that's right.
I don't want to jumble up my pattern.
No, got to think about where you're going. Okay.
Gosh, you're very quick.
Oh,
very,
look,
very quick.
I made some last week, so I've already had a bit of practice, haven't I?
That's true. I'm a bit of a necklace rookie. So
that's all right. Next time you make it, you'll be a pro, won't you? You can show everybody else. Yeah, how's that? I'm going to now tie a little knot in the middle so you can tie a bow. Again, if this is a bit tricky for you, just ask an adult for help. And it's just a simple knot there. Pull it tight. And just for a little bit extra, I will double knot it so my necklace doesn't fall apart. I'll be sad then. So that's nice and sturdy and strong. What do you think? I'll put that on over my hair. There we go.
That looks good. And mine isn't quite finished, but it's almost there.
Very good.
Tie my little knot.
That's okay. So yeah, as I said, you can talk about colors. You could go, look, I can see here, two blue, two green, two blue, two green. So that's a different pattern. I've just gone one color after the other. There you go, beautiful. If you'd like to make this at home, feel free to send us a photo in. We'd love to see what you get up to at home. And we hope to see you again soon. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
See everybody.